Welcome back, and we've been saying it all morning. It's another weather-worn day here from KTVO. The reason behind it, as you can see behind me from the Storm Prediction Center, their convective outlook for severe weather today has us underneath an enhanced risk outlook, which is this orange shading, because we are looking at a couple rounds of shower storms, possibly some severe weather headed our way this afternoon. We are going to be focusing in on that time frame during the afternoon hours, despite us dealing with some lingering showers and storms left over from last night. Now, we had these pulling through during our very early morning hours, and just about midnight to 1 a.m., we saw some very heavy showers and storms working their way through portions of northeast Missouri and our straggling areas out towards Fairfield, Mount Pleasant, as well as right up towards the Mississippi River, dealt with some lingering thunderstorms during these later morning hours, just about 5:30 or so. As for what we're going to be expecting heading through the rest of the day, so we have very warm temperatures across the area. Right now we have a lot of current temperatures in the mid and lower 60s. With that moisture hanging out around the area, thanks to that rainfall working its way through during the morning hours, we have that fog. However, what we're going to see is our upper air patterns is just pushing a lot of warm, wet Gulf of Mexico air towards our area. That's bringing with it plenty of more moisture. That's going to help create some very high rainfall amounts and very high rainfall rates as we get through these afternoon hours. Potential for severe storms is going to lie within this warm sector. Areas south of where the low pressure is, the low pressure system is kind of the catalyst behind a lot of our development, as well as a front that's going to work its way through as we go from Thursday into Friday. But prior to that, this warm area, this warm location here across most of Missouri and then encompassing a good portion of Iowa is going to be under the gun. But a lot of that upper air is moving in a way that is north and east, and that's pushing a lot of the extremely high rainfall rates just over the Mississippi River out in towards Illinois and Wisconsin. So we are going to be looking for extremely high rainfall amounts just east of our area, but we're going to be adding on a good amount of rain to areas that have already seen upwards of an inch and a quarter to an inch and a half. So throughout the day today, temperatures are going to work their way back up towards the 80s. Once again, upper 70s, low 80s. But by about 2 p.m., we're going to be concerned with a couple cells working their way in towards southeast Iowa. That's when we're going to be starting to talk about severe weather. Just about 2-3 p.m. and onwards is when we're going to be dealing with those conditions. And that's normally during the timeline of severe weather. The system we saw last night was it's a non-normal scenario where you're talking severe weather post-sundown into the early morning hours when you normally see a more stable environment. What we're looking at is the exact timeline you'd normally see it, 3 p.m. to 10 p.m. A bunch of training thunderstorms, meaning one after the other, are going to be impacting our area, especially here across southeast Iowa. And these are the areas that saw the highest rainfall amounts. Tumwa had over an inch. Out towards LBS saw an inch and a quarter to an inch and a half. So a bunch of us are going to be adding on an extra half of an inch, three quarters up towards an inch or so in those specific areas. But by 10 p.m., starting to see these showers and storms not developing continuously. We have a few stragglers working their way in during our late overnight and early morning hours, but then that cold front falls. We can see where that frontal location is once those winds out of the north work their way in. And from there on, a clearing effect is going to take place, leaving us with some sunny conditions to end Friday. And that's going to roll right on into Saturday and Sunday. We are looking at a gorgeous weekend and a great start to next week, but more rain is going to be on its way as we get into the middle portions of next week. Now stick with us. Tech Bites is coming up next.
Date. In fact, we're now learning that Meghan Markle's brother Thomas has sent a letter, in a handwritten letter to Prince Harry. Tom urged his future brother-in-law to cancel their wedding. Tom wrote that Meghan